place. My name is Sugi. You can also call me Candex or Dex for short. Today I thought I would do a candlelight meditation. I've done a couple of these on my channel before. I know they're not absolutely everyone's favorite, and not that they're something that people actively dislike, but I know that they're not as popular or asked for necessarily. But I felt called to do one today, and also feel like it would be good for me too, because it's quite meditative for me as well. My other videos can be relaxing for me too. This way I don't have to gear up for being perceived. And I've mentioned on my channel before that I get really insecure about what my skin looks like. So even like the act of putting on a tinted moisturizer or covering up with a CC cream is stressful for me, even though I really like playing with makeup. I don't have a specific theme in mind for today. My friend and I were having a conversation the other day, probably yesterday, about how this time feels like a historical and spiritual confrontation, and like all of the cells in our body are sort of vibrating really quickly to keep up with what's happening. Not in the sense that things that are happening are necessarily new, but that the energy that is being shared or felt feels collective and feels like revolution is in the air, you know. And so I think there's it's really important to find ways to decompress and validate what your body and your mind is going through. Sit with what you're learning and unlearning in this time. Sitting with and processing if you are learning a lot right now. And it can be a lot of people. It feels like it. For people who are in this work or are always sort of fighting, it can be a lot still. We're integrating a lot of different things, a lot of different strategies, and a lot of things are sort of physically coming into being, are coming into spaces. A lot of things are happening right now. Some of it is really heartbreaking. And some of it is really important and beautiful to see. For the first time, this is something that is a little bit of an update. For the first time since I started my channel in 2018, I finally am getting to see ad revenue from this channel, even though I've had ads up for a while. And it might not be a lot, but it's something. It's also important for me, coming from a place of a lot of like money trauma and like being in a space mentally where it felt wrong and bad to be ever making any money from anything. To recognize that I can always like recirculate anything that I make to community efforts. And also personally, coming to a space with like generating any kind of income, whether it is not a lot, which is kind of where I am now, or even if it could be more, that I am a person who deserves to live and survive and to eat, feed others, buy things for people that I love, but also sometimes even getting things for myself, which is hard for me. And it feels like probably this candlelight meditation is going to be not necessarily like very specific to one theme. It's sounding like it's going to be a little rambly, but if anybody is going through or experiencing any of the things that I'm going to be speaking on, or just finds candlelight meditations soothing, or my voice soothing, if any of this is helpful at all, I'm glad. And invite you to stay and get comfortable. These are our matches. And this is our candle. It's a little red tea light. I'm just gonna play with the matchbox a little bit. global pandemic that is going on still, to the ways that we are fighting for basic human rights for Black folk, wanting a different world and a different system, wanting different things for the ways that injustices have been normalized and show up in this world. In the ways that we're seeing and experiencing, what's happening right now. I just want to dedicate this time, dedicate this flame to being a space where people are being called and led to doing work. Dismantling relearning, unlearning, and choosing a different way forward. As well as recognizing and holding space for difficulties. People, it might be a lot of burnout at this time, getting overwhelmed by things that are happening right now in the world. Recognizing that it's important to stay in tune with what's going on. Recognizing that people are processing everything differently, but also recognizing that these are things that aren't necessarily new. There's a lot of things that people have not been made to see. We're not front page or deemed important by the news, and wanting to recognize and reframe for people that are waking up to this reality. To see what's really there, to see what's going on, to not be distracted, to not be confused by the illusions or things that might be brought up to distract from the work, or to blame people who are fighting. To see the flame for what it is. And at the same time, giving yourself space to take a breath, to recharge, because this work is not something that just happens right now. It's not something that you can just unplug from forever because some things have happened. This is continuous. About working towards believing in and fighting for a future that you might not have thought of before, you might not have seen before. Something freer. Magic than you might have let yourself believe. Taking time to breathe and center in on giving yourself time and space to challenge previously held beliefs, thinking about the ways that we're plugging in or giving to one another. How we're giving back to ourselves and investing in a world that looks and feels different. Which also requires healing on our own parts, trusting in each other and in our bodies, trusting in the capacity and desire to imagine a world and fight for a world, speaking up for a world, putting into practice the things, the gifts, the talents, the understandings, the spaces, the privileges, speaking your stories, recognizing that in absolutely everyone, there is a wealth of knowledges and ways that we can help each other. And also recognizing that there are reasons why this work is hard and that everybody has a lot of letting go and recalibrating to do. That the work is not always going to be comfortable or fun, but the freedom and the joy is worth it, knowing that we have to fight, that we have to believe that there are different ways for this world to be, for everyone to be thinking about humanity in ways that maybe aren't always on your minds. Recognizing that decompressing and finding space to process, giving yourself space to breathe and be in your body is part of this work. This time has been difficult for a lot of reasons. I think it's been challenging for people who struggle with mental health, even just like when conditions and different things that are happening aren't sort of dogpiling on one another. When people aren't being as exposed to so much violence all of the time, the ways that relationships to yourself and to others, to exercise or food, to different routines or dynamics, to different things that you might have identified with or need for your mental health or happiness or growth, that those things being shifted in so many different ways during this time can be really challenging and difficult. Giving space to that. Giving a breath to that. Acknowledging that. Acknowledging the tightness in your body, in your mind, things that feel stuck or feel like a lot of balled up tension. Giving a breath to that. Not letting go of it because it's important, but letting it be acknowledged, giving it space to loosen. Recognizing that there's a time and a place for every issue and concern, and it isn't effective to be concerned about absolutely everything at once. Sometimes you do have to think about and choose something to focus on, address it, and acknowledge it. Do that work. Or acknowledge it and recognize what and see what you can do about it, knowing that you have specific roles and you're not here to do everything. You can't do everything, and that doesn't make anybody weak. It just means that we are interdependent creatures, that we need each other. And that we need each other to be showing up and doing work in the ways that we're meant to. Knowing what your lane is, knowing what your role is, and doing that. Not that it has to be just one thing. You can move between roles, you can occupy more than one. Sometimes something will be your role for a while, and then sometimes it will shift. And that is perfectly valid and okay. But this is to say that it is important to recognize that you cannot do everything, and that is not something that you have to hold yourself to. Some people are fighters, some people are healers, some people are educators, some people connect others, some people do research or information or communication. Some people are meant to protect others. Some people are meant to be storytellers and visionaries. Some people have a lot to give, whether it's resources, time, energy, labor. And it's up to you to figure out what your role is or your roles are. It does not have to be just one. I'm just saying that to affirm anybody who is feeling like they have to be doing everything right now. Don't. That is no one's job. Includes our candlelight meditation. It wasn't necessarily guided, but hopefully. hopefully my rambly thoughts, thinking about the things that are going on at this time, giving some space to breathe, recognizing your worth and value, and that it's important to rest and decompress. Spend time to process is really important and necessary to this work and to your well-being. Thank you so much for being here and spending time with me in this space and spending some time resting.